rare earth elements, as the term implies, they seem to be rare, but they are not that rare. Actually, they are present everywhere, but the quantities that we are looking at and the amounts that we need are different. Very small quantities we use and small quantities we get from processing large quantities, of course. That is the reason we call them rare earths. These elements, they are there in parts per million. Sometimes it could be tens of parts per million, sometimes it could be hundreds of parts per million. But we have not looked at as a major resource because the demand was less and we didn't have to go to that resource. As the demand is growing and we are depending more and more on foreign sources for these, it has become extremely important from the national security standpoint to explore the possibilities. We're working with Texas Minerals in Venture and Jeddo Coal Company for this project. The talk of this collaboration started with our Energy Days in 2016 when these industries came to Penn State, and when we developed this process, they were interested in taking this to the next level also. So we wrote a joint proposal in 2016, and Department of Energy through NETL is funding this endeavor with all these partners. This project, when we originally started, it was Obama's administration. Now it is Trump administration. Both administrations are supporting this particular activity, where to get rare earth elements from coal, because it's the most logical and sensible way, because it's environmentally friendly, and we need these rare earth elements for all high-tech applications as well as energy applications. So he was really excited actually to come there and help the industry, because we're not mining any additional ones. We are actually using the same resources that we are mining, and we're going to be doing in an environmentally friendly way. So it was really exciting actually.